And every chain will break as broken hearts declare his praise. For who can stop the Lord Almighty? Our God is a lion, the Lion of Judah. He's roaring with power and fighting our battles, and every knee will bow before him. For the sins of the world, his blood breaks the chain, and every knee will bow before the Lion and the Lamb. Every knee will bow before him. Yeah. Oh, open up the gates, sing it out. So open up the gates, make way before the King of Kings. The God who comes to save is here to set the captives free. Who can stop the Lord Almighty? Come on, sing it out. Our God is a lion, the Lion of Judah. He's roaring with power and fighting our battles, and every knee will bow before him. Our God is the Lamb, the Lamb that was slain for the sins of the world. His blood breaks the chains, and every knee will bow before the Lion and the Lamb. Every knee will bow before him. Amen. Oh, who can stop the Lord Almighty? Who can stop the Lord Almighty? No one. Who can stop the Lord Almighty? No. Who can stop the Lord? Sing it over the banner. Lord, no one, no. Who can stop the Lord Almighty? No one. Who can stop the Lord Almighty? Who can stop the Lord? Yeah! Come on, let me hear you sing it this time. Our God is a lion, the Lion of Judah. He's roaring with power and fighting our battles, and every knee will bow before him. Our God is the Lamb, the Lamb that was slain for the sins of the world. His blood breaks the chains, and every knee will bow before the Lion and the Lamb. Every knee will bow before him. Oh. Yeah. Amen. You may be seated, but we want you to sing along with us. You're going to see words, so you can sing with us. Have a seat. We're so glad you joined us for our Christmas music today. We know that we hear Christmas music the whole time we're in our cars now. Every store we walk in, we're hearing Christmas songs. A few of these songs will seem familiar to you. Some of them may be kind of new, but they're all about us celebrating the birth of our Savior Jesus Christ. Amen? When God came down in human flesh and dwelt among us, perfect Son of God, perfect Lamb, and we're so grateful for that. Amen. Let's don't ever lose sight that that is what Christmas is about. In the midst of all your busyness, in the midst of all your gift buying and your struggling and fear over, anxiety over your finances, let's rest in knowing that God is still in control of this earth, and it's more important that we tell people about Jesus than it is anything else that we can give them. That's the greatest gift we can give. Amen.
Thank you. gonna be alright. It's time for Christmas morning. At first light, the tender hearts are warming. All year long we hope for something. Now look at this. All night long we kept the hours praying for this moment like this. Silent blessings strike the chord. Shout it out, Hosanna, Christ is born. Open up your heart, it's time for Christmas morning. All is quiet and the fire is still glowing. Grab a blanket, take my hand, I've started our list. Everything went before, for you know we've been blessed. Yeah, we the blessing strike the chord. Shout it out, Hosanna, Christ is born.
Y'all help me sing this one.
Angels we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plains, and the mountains in reply, echoing the joyous chant. Shepherds, why this jubilee? Why a joyous strains belong? What the glad sometimes.
on the day that you came. Salvation's reason to celebrate on the day that you came. How could heaven's heart not ring on the day, that you came? Salvation's reason to celebrate on the day. So blessed that you're here today to be with us. We're going to take just a brief portion of our service to continue in worship and give you a chance to give today. Anybody excited about that? Anybody excited about that? All right. We're going to receive our offering. There's three ways you can give. You can give online. You can give with the envelope that should be in front of you, or you can give through mobile text giving, which is what I do. We have the number up here. So let's pray for our offering today. God, we thank you for the abundant blessings you've given us as a church family and as your children, God. We know that you're a good father who gives good gifts and who gave the ultimate gift at Christmas, the Savior. And I pray that you just inspire us to be irrationally generous, God, in this season, to give to others, to be the light of the world, and to be the hands and feet of Jesus to the world around us. Pray that you'd keep us faithful in our tithes and offerings, keep us faithful, and keep our eyes on you through every difficulty, every obstacle in our life, that we continue to pursue you and glorify you with everything we say and do. We ask all these things in Jesus' name, and all God's people said amen. We want to remind you that we have a cry room. If you have a young one with you in the service today that gets a little fussy, you can take him right outside, and you continue to watch the service from there. And right now, I believe we have some special guests coming to join us, if they're ready. The children of Baby Nation are going to sing a song for us today. Have they been notified?
Maybe we'll do another song, and then maybe somebody can go find out.
That'd be great. Let's do another song.
Either that or there's babies run amok all over the building, probably. It's probably what's going on. They're lassoing them.
All right.
What if I told you you have the power? Give someone hope far beyond their wildest dreams. What if I told you it's right there in your hands? In your hands. It's hard to imagine something so small make all the difference, tear down the tallest wall. What if December look different this year? What if we all just give this Christmas away? give someone hope far beyond the wildest dream.
What if December looked different this year?
Now what if we all just give this Christmas away?
Ladies and gentlemen, Baby Nation, let's hear it for them.
Great job. Got some future worship team members there, right? All right, we're going to see our video announcements.
Thank you. Thank you for joining us here today at Fellowship of the Nations. Here's what we have coming up. Baby Nation is once again hosting a preschool toy drive for ages 4 and under. So bring your wrapped gift to Baby Nation by December the 24th and be a blessing to a family in need this Christmas. As you do your shopping for Christmas this year, please remember the special Christmas offering given over and above your regular tithes that will go to the FOTN missions around the world. We will have a special offering time on Christmas Eve morning so you and your family may give together. The FOTN offices will be closed December the 25th through the 30th, but you may still give online through mobile text giving during that week. We are having a special family service next Sunday at 11 a.m. on Christmas Eve Day. So come and join us for a special time of Christmas carols and hearing the story of Christ's miraculous birth from Pastor Johnny. There will be no 9 a.m. groups or ministries that day. So from all of us at Fellowship of the Nations, we want to wish you and yours a beautiful and a very Merry Christmas. Everybody, go out and have a great week.
This Christmas will be different. Sure, the tree is up, the cookies will be baked, the parties and presents will happen like they always do, and the children will sit on Santa's knee and whisper their fondest wish for a magical Christmas morning. But this Christmas, someone I love is no longer here with me, and that makes everything different. Life has a tendency to hit us broadside, doesn't it? A marriage doesn't make it. A friend gets cancer. A child drifts away from the safety of God's plan. A loved one dies, leaving us asking the hard questions, the ones that keep us up at night and shake us to the core of our existence. Where are you, God? Why have you forsaken me? I feel so alone. I can't do this without you. And we hear only silence, like the falling of snow on a moonless night, the nothingness, the void, and we wonder, are we alone? But the reality of Christmas reminds me that God thought each of us so valuable, so special, so necessary to His plan, that He made a way for us all to know Him intimately and put a plan in place to pursue us with relentless love in order to reconcile us to Himself. We're each broken, scarred by sin, wounded by thoughtless mistakes and missteps, living under the curse of death from our first breath, and yet God, in His infinite mercy and love, reached down from heaven, made a way for us to know Him by sending a perfect baby boy, the Lamb of God, to take our place. Christmas forever changed the course of mankind, opening the pathway for generations to understand the love of an eternal God through Jesus Christ. And because of that reality, I know I'm not alone. Because of that truth, I know that even death cannot separate me from His love. This Christmas, I'll worship the newborn King, and I'll celebrate the glorious kingdom to come, where there will be no more tears, no more sorrow, and no more goodbyes. Here's wishing you the merriest Christmas ever as you celebrate the birth of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Merry Christmas, friends.
Shall reign forevermore.
I would do my part, but I am poor. I will give to him my heart, and he shall reign forevermore, forevermore. He shall. A sacrifice, the Christ the Messiah, into our hopes, into our fears, the Savior of the world appears, the promise of eternal years, the Christ the Messiah, and he shall reign forevermore, forevermore.
Star and angels gave the sign. Bow to babe on bended knee, the Savior of humanity. Unto us a child is born. He shall reign forevermore. No way. Story of amazing love, the light.
we're coming to a close in just a moment. Before we do, I want to just say in this time of season of thankfulness, how thankful I am to have been able to play with this band for another year. And I hope you've been blessed by the music that we play and the worship that we lead up here. But I just wanted to take just a moment to introduce them if I could. Over here on drums is Don Rosecrans. This is Chad Ware back here on the guitar. Pastor Stephanie Santos. Marian Aquilina. Pastor Lisa Brady. This is Lindsay Dukes. And with us since day one, Lori McGee. I'm just so blessed to be able to play with these world-class musicians, and it's just a lot of fun. And when you get to do something that you love, it's always a blessing, amen. And we also have an amazing media team and sound people. And can we give them a hand? The people do the cameras, people do the lights, people do the lyrics, the live stream back there. If you see them around after the service, maybe give them a hug. Tell them how much you love and appreciate them, because we don't do it enough, do we? So just want to thank you guys and ask you to stand with us and join us for the last song of worship.
You are the first. You go before. You are the last. Lord, you're the encore. Your name's in lights for all to see. In starry hosts, declare your glory. Glory in the highest.
Sing your praise.
glory in the high. Oh, let your worship rise. Oh, to you, Lord, to you, Lord, to you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. Oh, we give you praise. We give you praise. We lift your name on high, Lord.
And the people said, amen. Hey, let's give just a big hand clap to the Lord. And thank you. You guys did an incredible job. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. As we go into our time of invitation, just let me say this, and I want you to think about this. In the time where you're spending a lot of time maybe online, if you're smart, or in stores, you're looking for those gifts and that perfect gift because you love your kids and your spouses and different ones in your family and friends. You want to give them that perfect gift. But let me tell you what the perfect gift is. It's a relationship with Jesus Christ. You see, when you look at the gift, the Bible says that the wages of our sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ. You see, when you look at this particular gift and you unwrap it and you take the top off and you really look at what salvation is, what this gift is, you look in there and there's adoption. You receive the gift, and part of that gift is you become the child of God Almighty. That's part of that gift. But you look in there also, and you look there, and you see pardon of sin. That every sin that we've ever committed has been washed away by the blood of Jesus himself. And you look in there also, and you see the gift of Holy Spirit who says, I will now indwell your body. And I will be your power, and I'll be your wisdom, and I'll be your comfort and your peace, and I'll be everything you need, and I will never leave you, and I will never forsake you. And then you look also, and you see that Jesus, who is the light of the world, that even the darkest of times that we have and the times that we need direction, you see that God there is light, and he will give us light even in the darkness. When we see that light at even at the end of the tunnel, it seems like, Lord, how do I get out of this situation? We see he's our light. Then we look in there, we also see he's our bread of life. That he's our sustainer and he's our provider and he's our Jehovah Jireh who meets all of our needs according to his riches and glory. We say, God, in time of need, all kinds of needs, physically, spiritually, mentally, emotionally, financially, that you're our bread of life and you give it to us daily, as he did the children in the wilderness, the manna from heaven. We look in again and we see that there's a home in heaven that Jesus says, I'm going to go away and I'm going to prepare a place for you. And if I go prepare a place for you, I'm going to come back and receive you unto myself, that where I am, that's where you're going to be also. The hope of the future that we have with him. You see, this is all just a portion of the box that we call the gift of salvation. It's everything we need. It's the perfect gift. Many of you here in this room, you've already received that gift. You know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. But God Almighty is saying to some this morning, here's my gift. It's here. I've already paid for it. And all you have to do is take it. For some here today, you need to do that. You will make life's greatest decision if you will come and take the gift of salvation. So right now, we want to give you an opportunity. So with heads bowed and eyes closed, I want you to take a look in your heart, because the Bible says to as many as received that gift, to them he's given them a new life. He's transformed them. He has changed them. I want you to go back at a time to say, has that ever really happened in my life? Have I truly been changed? Have I been transformed? Have I become a new creation in Christ? Has my way of living changed? Has my attitudes changed? Has there really been a change in my life? For some, you look back and you say, well, I did that years ago. I think I did, but now I'm not 8 anymore, but I'm 58, and things have never been the same. I've just been the same old me, and the same attitudes and the things that I used to do, I'm still doing, and I don't see a change in my life, but I want one. Then receive the gift of Jesus. He is the way, he's truth, and he's life. So right now, I believe the Holy Spirit is speaking to you. And whether or not you're saved or you're lost, and he's whispering in your ear like he did to me when I was 17 years of age, and he whispered and he let me know, you're lost. And it was the greatest awakening that I ever had in my life. Because once he showed me that I was lost, he showed me that I could be saved right then. And for some, you need to be saved today. That's why he's pulling back the curtain really to your life and showing you, that it's not about you being a good person, because none of us are good enough to get there. It's about whether you have a true relationship with Jesus Christ. Not a church member, a relationship. Not religious, a relationship. And if you do not have that, then allow yourself to put pride aside and worry about what people may say about me if I was to walk to the front and admit I'm lost and I am in need of a Savior. This baby who was born on Christmas night grew up to be the Lamb of God who takes away my sin. I want him. So right where you are, you can ask him to come in and to save you. With his head bowed and eyes closed, let me ask this question. Is there anyone here that the Holy Spirit has whispered, I am lost, but I need a Savior?
Thank you so much for being a part of our online streaming. I hope you really enjoyed the message today. And I want you to just take it to heart. Whatever the Lord has spoken to you, just take it to heart. And I pray that if you have never received Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, that today would be that day. The Bible says today is the day of salvation. So that's what we're praying for you. And if you're wondering, how do I get to know Jesus as my Lord and Savior? Well, let me tell you, it's pretty simple. First of all, Jesus loves you more than anybody on this planet. So let me tell you, he's wanting you to know him. So as you come to him, we recognize, one, that we've sinned against God. Everybody has. The Bible says that all have sinned. We've fallen short of the glory of God. Well, we recognize that one. We don't have to be told that. We know that. The second thing is, it says that God demonstrated his love for us, and that's you. God loves you even though that we were sinners. That's how much he cares for you. So you got to get it out of the way. He's not judging you. He already sent his son to die in our place so that we could have all of our sin placed upon him. And then we believe, we had faith in him, that that's what he did. And he did it because he loved us. The Bible says the wages of our sin is death. Well, Jesus took our death sentence for us. But then it doesn't leave it as a negative. It says, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus. It's not works. It's not a church membership somewhere. It's not giving money to somebody. All of those are good things, but this does not bring salvation. So now, how do you get there? It's only in Jesus. So simply just open your heart and say, Jesus, I'm a sinner. Please forgive me of my sin. Come into my heart. Save me. Forgive me. I want to turn away from all the stupid stuff that I'm doing. And I want to turn to you. I want you to be my Lord, my Savior, the boss of my life. And Jesus, come in and save me. I want to love you. I want to live for you. I want to obey your word. all the days of my life. And that's what you can do. Pray that prayer right now. And I tell you, Jesus is waiting. And the moment, the instant you do that, you will be saved. And my encouragement to you, find a great Bible-believing, Bible-preaching church. Get connected. Now, if you're in the Houston area, man, we would love to have you at Fellowship of the Nations. But you're in different parts of the country or even around the world, find somewhere that they're preaching Jesus. And I promise you, it will change your life. Hope you can join us again next week. And up until then, we'll be praying for you. Pray for us. We'd love to hear from you. Just go on our website, FOTN.org, Fellowship of the Nations, and let us hear from you. God bless you.